I'm Robert Dowling, been a photographer for 45, 46 years. Still at it sometimes. I just drifted into it through advertising agency, through a graphic design company, and into a darkroom. And the darkroom was where I began to see really nice work. And even then, I realised it was good stuff. Being very young and precocious and upsetting one or two people on the way, I thought I could do it all straight away. But of course you can't, because you don't actually learn in this job until you do it yourself. And it didn't take me long to discover that it was pretty hard. Setting up a 10-8 camera for the first time and trying to shoot soup, or whatever it was I started with, should have taken a couple of hours. It took me 2 days, you know. That's how you learn. Like all careers, it goes up and down. I started in the record business, and it was a good way of earning a living. And like all things, you do something really daft, like a broken down piano for an album sleeve for Eddie Boyd or something like that. And someone in an agency sees it, they got a picture of piano in their shop, and so they commission you to take a boring picture of an organ in Bromley. But from that, you then build relationships with people. And all the way through my career, you get people that you get on with well, that give you a range of work and believe in what you can do. There's never more than two or three or four of them, if you're lucky, at any one time. And then if they drop out, someone else might come in. But basically, you build on those relationships. So there's a relationship of trust. I was commissioned, I'm sure, not because of the photography I did, but because I could guarantee that I'd deliver. I've had assistants who are absolutely brilliant photographers, better than I could ever be. And they weren't successful. They were good photographers, but they weren't successful. And then you get successful photographers that aren't good photographers. In the commercial world at that time, it wasn't hard to see what you needed. You had to be a balance of all things. You had to be a bit of a businessman, good organiser, good with people. And at the end of it, the last 10% was the photography. So if my reputation is built on the fact that, say, I did something for the Pink Floyd, well, yeah, but it wasn't the best picture I ever took. It was somebody's idea that I interpreted in a way for them. I solved the problem. And if that means that I'm a good photographer, it's meaningless to me. It doesn't mean a thing. What is nice is when somebody whose opinion you really value recognises a picture. But you always feel like you've never done good enough. So you can look back at all your stuff and think, yeah, well, I could have done better. I could have done this better, I could have done that better. I still think I can do better.